Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another movie review. It's been a long time since I've done one. What spurred me on is to do a review for my film class, English 344, that I'm taking this year. And today, I'm going to be talking about the Best Picture winner, directed by Norman Jewison, starring Sidney Poitier and Rod Steiger, and that is In the Heat of the Night, from 1967. I actually watched this on my copy of the movie on Criterion DVD, which looks great, and I really liked it. And honestly, I really, really, really liked this movie a lot more than I was expecting to. Before watching this, I wasn't familiar with Rod Steiger, Norman Jewison, or Sidney Poitier, even though I had heard of his name. And I knew that this was a Best Picture, but I was very excited to watch it for film class, especially because I would have the chance to talk about it with a lot of people who had seen it. And while I was watching the movie, I have been taking notes in a little booklet that I've been using for about a month now. And this was the first time that I took so many notes, so many positive notes. You can see on this side, there's pluses all the way down the side, that I actually went onto another page, and that had never happened before. I took so many positive notes, that's how much I like this movie. Now, the real clear center of this film is Sidney Poitier and his performance, which just blew me away, and I ended up watching a couple other of his movies after that just to sort of get a better idea of what his career was like. But he is the center of this movie. He is the main character, Virgil Tibbs. He's a northern detective who is visiting the South and gets caught up in a whole murder mystery with a corrupt police station. And this movie uses his performance at the center of the film to really show how corrupt the police can be, even back in the 60s, and what it's like being an African-American man in a city that is full of just racist people and the prejudices that they have against him. And it really gives you a clear understanding of the vibe that this town has and how they feel about him being a black man in the South, but being conflicted that he is a police officer. He's very good at his job, and he's kind of the one who knows what's going on, even if he is outnumbered ridiculously. The main aspect of Sidney Poitier's performance and his character, Virgil Tibbs, in this movie is the idea of power struggles throughout the film. Tibbs is the one with the moral high ground in this situation. He hasn't done anything wrong. And the reason the cops are mad at him for any reason in this film is just because they're prejudiced against him. The only reason that the cops have any power over him is because of their role as police officers in the city. And even though they don't know what's going on and they don't have all the information and they're not quite as good at their jobs as he is at his, they still feel like they want to have power. And that's where the power struggle really comes in. This is further expanded upon later in the movie when the cops realize that they do need him to help them because they don't know what they're doing, and he's the one that has the real information and the skill to solve the mystery. They don't really want him to help until there's something in it for them, whether that be solving something to make themselves look good or to help their town overall, which is a plot point that feeds into the greater narrative. The power struggle and the narrative is actually mirrored to the cinematography of the movie that Norman Jewison has sort of put together. There's a lot of really nice establishing shots that go super, super wide, but that's also intercut with different scenes that are a lot more intimate, such as a scene where Sidney Poitier is examining a body, and it's entirely in extreme, extreme close-up, and you get a lot of focus and depth. And the balance between the faraway establishing shots and the really close-up intimate shots, as I said, mirrors the power balance and the struggle between him knowing what he's doing and figuring out his place in the world. One thing that I personally love a lot in movies is something that's not very difficult to do and not very uncommon, but is setups and payoffs that really work through the course of the entire movie. And this film, In the Heat of the Night, just has that in droves. There are things that are set up in the first few sequences of the movie that seem mundane or don't make any sense that have major payoffs later in the film. And that really makes it exciting for me because I do want to rewatch this movie, which is something that I don't really say most of the time. This film also has a really interesting use of color. Most of the film, or a lot of the film, takes place in the nighttime, in the heat of the night. I know, surprising. But during those nighttime shots, you get a lot of gray and darkness because of the lack of lighting. But they also use a lot of colored signs and splashes of colored light that really give it a really unique feel. And it's sort of mirrored in the box art here, where you can see, imagine that the red is a black, but they have the lights of signs and lampposts that really give it a nice color palette, even though a lot of it is pretty dark. But to bring it full circle and go back to Sidney Poitier's performance as Virgil Tibbs, he actually replayed the performance in a later film that I have not seen. but he plays this character with a really nice stone-cold attitude during the beginning where it really shows his power. He really does not let things faze him. And even though there's all this really crappy stuff happening to him, especially at the beginning of the film and near the end, he always remains his composure. He knows that he is in the right for these things, and he knows that he believes in himself and his skill, even when that's questioned to really high magnitudes by everyone around him. Aside from Sidney Poitier, there is a really nice surrounding cast of characters that all have very unique personalities. And although most of them are racist Southern people, they do have their points in the story where they redeem themselves to some degree, and the characters are able to build bonds with Virgil Tibbs, realizing that he does know what he's talking about and he is a good cop. And that, especially with Rod Steiger playing, I think the name is Gillespie, they have a pretty good back and forth there. Their banter and their both of their performances and their chemistry together really works. Rod Steiger's performance as Gillespie with the chewing of the gum, and that replaces what a lot of characters would have in movies in that time with flipping a coin or smoking a cigar. He was chewing gum, and it really gives that character a unique feel. And in some ways, a lot of those cops, the racist Southern people, almost have a cartoonish vibe to them. They have really weird names. I have some written down here. Shagbag, Fryer. These are cartoony, you know, Saturday morning cartoon names that are kind of ridiculous. And it plays into the fact that they have just corrupted themselves to the nth degree. They don't really know what they're doing. They play everything on their power alone and not their actual knowledge. And it's a nice balance to the fact that this outsider who does know what he's talking about comes in and just completely steals the show. And that's what the movie is about, with Sidney Poitier completely taking center stage and everything else sort of just happening around him and to him. In the end, this is just a movie I liked a lot. I'm very glad I got to watch for class. I'm able to make a review and get a grade on it. Hopefully I get a good grade on this. I think I'm going to be adding some footage over it, which I haven't done in previous reviews, but I want to sort of make it a little more visually interesting for my teacher, so it's not just my face talking to you the entire time. But thank you very much for watching. I give this movie a 9 out of 10. I really enjoyed it. It's one of my favorite Best Picture winners, actually. There's a few things that I could critique about it, where I think that some scenes sort of just stop and end very quickly. There's a lot of transitions that feel a little bit jarring, but overall the film is wonderfully paced, and those moments just don't take away from the experience overall, which is why I'm giving it a 9 out of 10. And I really highly recommend watching it if you haven't. There's a lot of twists and surprises and a lot of interesting characters, and especially Sidney Poitier's performance, I think, is worth watching the movie alone. And I can't wait to watch it again, and I really hope you guys enjoyed me talking about it. So thank you for watching.